My name is Nadine Redlich. Thank you, it's nice that for having me. And a big thank you to Liv and Lucy, who always write such nice things about my work on the website. And thank you all for coming tonight and for listening to me, talking about myself and about my work. I'm a cartoonist, by the way, and also a very stable genius. The truth is, I'm really, really nervous right now. And if I fuck this up, please don't upload it to the internet. Thanks. So now I will show you some of my work. This is a croissant. No, seriously, I'm going to show some pages of my previous books and then go more into detail about my latest book. I start with ambient comics. It contains stress and tension relieving comics. I wanted it to look as formal and impersonal as possible. So, as you may have seen before, my drawings are a little bit wonky and wobbly. So I started drawing them with a ruler and other technical drawing instruments. And later on, I discovered the magic of Photoshop. So now I will show you some of the pages of the book. Breathe in and breathe out. Close your eyes only if really necessary. The ISBN number of this book is 978-3940-304-57-5. I also have some copies with me. That's it for ambient comics. I'll be right back after a short break.
You cannot keep interrupting. I'm having a conversation. Walter, I'm right here, baby.
Paniktotem. This is my stress opus. It's a collection of cartoons and comics I did, I guess, between 2014 and 16, or something like that, where I just put all the drawings I made that can contain an underlying feeling of stress and discomfort into a book. Here are a few examples. There are a lot of dogs in the book. This particular dog has a problem with his work-life balance. This is what I look like naked. This comic strip is about the horror of waking up in the morning. Some of the illustrations I also made in little GIFs. As you can see, many of my strips are already very close to animations. I'm fine, by the way. No worries. Never been better. This is probably my most successful joke from the book. From here on, it's going downhill. This is a cartoon about love. Or to be more specific, about relationships and codependency and claustrophobia. So I guess the topics of my latest book were already there. This is a housewife and a smashing keynote effect. I was told by many of my single friends that this pineapple gif got really popular on Tinder. Creepy. Here's another dog pooping. Man, I love keynote effects. That's it for Paniktotem. Now to my latest project. A tiny book called I Hate You, You Just Don't Know It Yet. Just because it's hard to love somebody, especially over a long period of time. At first, I want to show you a little bit about my general work process. It always starts with an idea. The idea is still a little bit vague maybe, but just the right amount of vague so that you can't anticipate the struggles and the work that will come with realizing this idea. Therefore, you right away think, that's it, what a brilliant idea. I'm a stable genius after all. I feel like I can do anything right now. As a result, you're going to pitch this brilliant idea to your publisher, and you're really, really confident that it will only take you like 3 to 4 weeks maybe to finish the whole project. Then the worst thing that can happen happens. Publisher says, yes, great idea, let's do it. And you have a deadline. The publisher, of course, will have a little bit more foresight than you and puts the deadline to spring. This is the summer the year before, by the way. Now that you have the deadline, your confidence collapses like a soufflé and gets replaced by the fear of disappointing others. So now you do nothing. But just before the deadline, let's say right about here, the fear of disappointing others by doing bad work gets replaced by the fear of disappointing your publisher by doing no work at all. Therefore, you start working night and day like an animal and pretend you did this all along, and deliver the work at the very last minute to the annoyance of everybody involved. I hope my publisher doesn't see this, but she probably knows anyway. She's really smart. Love you, Rita. Back to the book. By the way, this process is unnecessarily stressful, but I guess there's something to it. By putting a seed in your head and let your brain ponder on it while you do other things, and you later come back to harvest these ideas. What a beautiful metaphor. Jeez. Back to the book. I got the idea and the title for the book from an old drawing I found in my sketchbook. It's a couple lying in bed. One of them is sleeping. The other one is watching him or her lovingly and whispers, I hate you. You just don't know it yet. The thought cracked me up so much, I wanted to make a book out of it. So it became the title of the book, and the rest is something you would only whisper into your partner's ear while he or she is asleep. Once I had the underlying feeling for the book, I produced a lot of sketches to illuminate this feeling. But I didn't want to put that much energy into these drawings, because, as you already know, I was moving pretty fast towards the deadline. And I also thought it would be creepy to put a lot of ambition into a book that is called I Hate You, You Just Don't Know It Yet, like some kind of serial killer's diary with glued in hair or something like that. Therefore, I decided to just sketch everything with colored ink. As you can see here, the drawings are very simple, but you still can see the structure of the ink, so I was relatively pleased with the results and started producing them a lot and scanned them all in and retouched them in Photoshop and blah, blah, blah. Little did I know that at the end I will decide to print the book with special color and end up scanning everything and retouching it again because I had to scan it black and white. Genius. Now I shut up and show you some pages which made it into the book. That was uplifting. To end on a little bit lighter note, I would like to show you what I'm working on right now. This is a reoccurring character of mine, a stone. I'm working on new strips right now because, of course, I already promised to Rita, my publisher, that there will be a book next spring. This is him in action. That's it. Thank you for listening.